Are you ready to study this summer, raise your SAT score, go to the college of your dreams, and make your parents proud? Are you ready to do that? If you are, I can help you with that. So the long-awaited study guide for the summer is now ready. So here's what we're gonna do. First, we're gonna go down there in the description box down below. There's going to be a link to the summer study plan. It's gonna look something like this. And we're gonna go over that. I'm gonna teach you exactly how to use this study guide to get the maximum results out of it in the smallest, shortest time possible. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna go down there, print this video out. Print this paper out. So pause the video here and go print it out. Like, don't be that one kid who doesn't print this out and just watches the video. Like, you're not gonna get the most out of it. So take a second, print this out. And while you're studying with this study plan right here, here's the thing. You are going to get stuck. You're gonna have questions. And when you do get stuck, you can ask me by joining our Facebook group. It's a community of high school students who are highly motivated to raise their SAT score. And I'm also in there. So any questions that you guys post in there, can get some help from me. So go down below while this thing is printing, go join the Facebook community. And the third, the most important thing here is make sure you smash the like button and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, because this is part one of the summer study plan. And I'm gonna also release a part two in a bit. So you wanna be notified when the part two drops and take advantage of part two as well. So like button, subscribe, and turn the notification bell on. And if you are good to go, let's jump into the computer and let's go over the summer study plan. So let's go over the summer study plan. So if you download it and print it out, the first page is gonna look something like this. It's gonna break it down day by day by day, and it's going to be about 28 days long. So on day one, you're gonna learn about fractions. And on day two, squaring. And third day, what you're gonna do is you're gonna take a day off, okay? And during this time, what you're gonna do is you're gonna review the past two concepts that you have covered for the past 2 days. And once everything is fresh in your head, then you're gonna move on to exponents, percents, and then take another day to review these things on top of these things. And on the seventh day, we are going to take a little break, because even if you want to study 30 days in a row, it's not realistic. What's gonna happen is that you're going to get burnt out and you're gonna need about 4 or 5 days off in order to get back to your feet. Studying every single day without a break is not realistic. Trust me, I've tried it. A lot of my students have tried it. It's just not realistic. And the next day, you're gonna learn about functions, quadratics, and then take a day off, and then study systems of equation. And right here, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go back and review every single one of these concepts that we have learned so far. Because when you are right here, you're mainly focused on the materials you have learned from this week, which means these things are going to be shaky in your head. And the thing about the SAT is that these things will also show up on the SAT. So spend 2 days to review everything and make sure everything's stuck in your head. The SAT will test you every single one of these concepts on this study plan, so you don't want to forget any one of them. So take some time to review every single concept that you have covered so far and make sure they are still with you by the time you get to the 28th day. And after that, again, it's the 7th day mark, so take a little break, rest up a bit, and you can pick it up again on the next day with absolute values. And that cycle is going to repeat for 2 more weeks. Does that make sense? So that is going to be the overall study plan for phase one. The phase two is going to be about practice exams, and that's going to be released in about a week or two. So let's talk about how you can access every single one of these lecture videos. So if you look down here, there's going to be a link, lecture links to every single one of these lectures, right? So the first thing you want to do is you want to go over the introduction, right? How to correctly study the lectures and solve practice questions. This is a very unique program that I've made for you guys, and there is going to be a very unique way to approach this study plan. If you do it any other way, chances are you're going to be doing it inefficiently and you're going to spend more time and get less result out of it. So the very first thing you need to do is by watching this introduction video and learn how to use this study plan. And when you're done with the introduction, go to the fractions lecture, and you will see that there is going to be a little asterisk to fractions and squaring lecture. So these two lectures are right there actually are from the SAT Math Accelerator program that I've recently released, which is essentially a 2.0, better and improved version of the original videos that you've been seeing on free lectures. The thing is, these two chapters are very important when it comes to SAT math prep, and the old videos did not have these two concepts in there. So I've made these two lectures available for free, and think of them as like a little preview to the course if you were ever considering joining the program. So you will have access to the lecture for these videos, and you will also have a set of practice questions. And for these two chapters, what you're going to also have is going to be a video explanation for all the practice questions that are in the practice set. So whenever you get stuck on a question, you can follow along with the video and get a visual explanation on exactly how to solve the question and why you were stuck. Does that make sense? Cool. So let me show you how to use these lecture links. So when you download the study guide, you're going to come across a page that looks like this. And if you click these blue links right here, for example, let's click fractions, what's going to happen is going to open up the lecture link. So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to download the lecture worksheet. This is a worksheet that goes along with this video down here. And once you have everything ready, you're going to play the video and you're just going to follow along. And it's going to explain every single step of the way. You can solve the questions along with it. And if you get stuck, just leave a comment down below and I'll help you out on how to get the answer. And once you're done with the lecture and understood everything, you're gonna summarize the concept in this concept summary worksheet. You can download it, print it out, and then summarize it. And once you have everything in your head, what you're gonna do is you're gonna go to the practice set. Okay. And on the practice set, it's going to be about 12 questions right here, and they also have answer key toward the end. And if there's a question you really don't understand how to solve, I recommend you try to solve it a couple more times. But if you still don't get it, then you can always come down to the solution video, and it's going to explain how to solve the question every single step. Does that make sense? And as always, if you don't get something, you can leave a comment down below, and I can help you out. Does that make sense? Cool. So let's go back to the PowerPoint. And that's exactly what you're going to do for every single one of these lectures. Okay? So let's go over in more detail on how to prepare for each of the concepts, right? It's going to be a four-step process. So the very first thing you're going to do is by watching the concept lecture, right? So these lectures, they only cover the materials that are actually on the exam. Meaning, if it's on the SAT, it's on the lecture. But if it's not on the lecture, it's not on the SAT. So everything that is covered in the lecture, make sure you understand every single one of them. Because if you don't, it's going to show up in the SAT and you're going to get that question wrong. Okay. And while you're watching the lecture, make sure you focus on understanding the concept and how they work. Okay. So on the worksheet, if you look at it carefully, it's going to say focus on understanding rather than memorizing. Okay. Don't memorize how to do certain things, but rather understand why things work a certain way. And after you're done with that, the second step is to summarize and memorize everything that we have covered from the concept lecture, right? So on this summary worksheet, what you're going to do is you're going to summarize the key concepts on a separate notebook. So you can either summarize it on your notebook or you can summarize it on the concept summary worksheet. And while you're doing that, make sure you understand it and memorize every single point before you try practice questions. Don't go to the practice questions when you don't understand something, because you're not going to be able to solve those questions. And the third step is going to be practice questions. Once you have summarized and memorized everything, it's time to test yourself on whether you understood the concepts or not, right? So when it comes to these practice questions, right, it's all about piecing the learned materials together. If you get stuck on a question, you're just having trouble piecing the information together. You have all the necessary information and knowledge to solve the questions. It's just a matter of piecing the information together, right? So when you get stuck on a question, think back to the covered concepts. Don't think about anything else. Think about what was covered in the lecture, and the question will be able to be solved with either one of them or in a mix of the few concepts. Does that make sense? So when you get stuck on a question, think about within the materials you have learned. It's going to be one of them or a mix of a couple of them. And the fourth step is going to be review. While you're doing practice questions, what's going to happen is you're going to miss a couple of questions. And those wrong questions essentially tell you which concepts you are weak on, right? So practice question essentially digs out and highlights exactly which questions, which concepts you are weak on, and which ones you need to review. And this part is going to be covered more on phase two, but let me just briefly summarize what you should do. Whenever you miss a question, think about why you missed that specific question. Was it a concept issue, as in you didn't know the concept that was needed to solve the question? Or was it like a critical thinking? You knew all the concepts, but you just didn't know how to piece everything together, which is known as critical thinking. And every single one of these questions, what you want to do is you want to highlight them and you want to look at them until you completely understand these wrong questions. Because SAT is all about repetition. These questions that you'll see on the practice set, they were built to mimic the actual SAT questions. The wordings, the styles, and the difficulty, they are all designed to mimic the actual SAT. So chances are if you missed any of these questions, that means you are going to miss a similar question when it reappears on the actual SAT and when it actually matters. So when you get a question wrong, don't just sweep it under the rug. Actually spend time to understand why you got the question wrong and how you can get it right the next time. Does that make sense? So that's going to be the overall steps to prepare for each of these concepts. Watch the lecture, summarize the lecture, do the practice questions, and review the lecture. And if you can do that diligently, I promise you, your score will go up. So that's going to be the big picture of the study plan. But let's go over the little nitty-gritty stuff you need to keep in mind while you are preparing. So the first thing is going to be go through the chapters in order, right? So these chapters have been carefully arranged. It's not like I randomly decided to put fractions here, exponents here, and then quadratics here. No, they have been ordered carefully. And that's because you will need the materials from the first weeks to understand the materials from the second week. For example, you'll need to understand fractions, squaring, exponents, and percents to understand what's going to be taught in the functions, quadratic, and systems equations lecture. Because math is like a pyramid. You learn the basics, and by using the basics, you learn the more complicated stuff. And by learning the more complicated stuff, you learn even more complicated stuff. But if you don't understand the very basic stuff, then all these things are going to be very tough for you to understand. So make sure you go through the chapters in order. And if there's a chapter that you are familiar with, then you may be able to brush through them like quickly. Maybe you can set the video on 2x and watch through the videos quickly and go through the practice questions super quickly, but do not skip them. Second thing you need to remember is that if it's in the lecture, it's on the SAT. Remember, right? When you don't understand something during the lecture, you'll be really tempted to just kind of skip them and brush them under the rug. But please, don't do that. That's not what you want to do. These concepts that you just skipped over on, they will definitely show up on the exam, and you'll get them wrong in the future if you don't understand them now. So you can be more diligent and you can either pay the price now, or you can get the question wrong and pay the price when it actually matters. So if it's in the lecture, it's on the SAT. Next thing, So we have a lot of steps here, but step two is the most important step. Step two is going to be summarizing and memorizing what you have learned from the constant lecture, right? Here's an example. See, if you don't know how to add, then you'll never be able to know what 1+1 is, no matter how hard you try or how much time you have. So before you try any of these practice questions, make sure you understand everything, and I mean every single thing, and have important equations and concepts in your head. Otherwise, you'll get stuck on these practice questions, get frustrated, and you're gonna get them wrong, and you're not gonna wanna study for the SAT. So among all of these four steps right here, step number two, summarizing and memorizing is literally the most important steps. The next thing is about these practice questions you're gonna do after summarizing the lectures, right? These questions, the easy ones, you might know how to solve them off the bat, but the hard ones, when you get stuck, just remember this. You know how to solve them, just not yet. See, the thing is, you have learned everything you need to solve these practice questions. And if you can't solve that question, it comes down to two things. You either first don't have the concepts in your head, or you're just having trouble piecing the information together, right? You just need to try to piece the learned materials together a couple more times. So if your problem is number one, then what you need to do is you need to go back to your notes and make sure you understood everything and memorized everything before you try the practice questions. But if it's number two, where you're just having trouble piecing the information together, then just give it like 10 more minutes, try a couple more times, and think within the materials you have learned in the lecture. If you do that often enough, you'll be able to solve the question, no problemo. So guys, this is a lot of information to take in. And if any of these steps don't make sense on the way, leave a comment down below with your question, and I'll write out some extra stuff so that you will understand it. Let's keep going, we're almost there. So the next thing you need to remember is that, you know, step two is very important, but step four is the next most important step. It's the second most important step. So the fourth step is going to be reviewing your wrong questions, right? So when you get a question wrong, you need to always think about why you missed a question and how you can get it right the next time. That's because if you don't understand why you made your mistakes or why you couldn't solve the questions, then when the same question shows up again, which it will on the SAT, then you will make the exact same mistake next time and get the question wrong again next time. And if you keep missing questions, your score is going to be lower and you'll never be able to improve your score. So as much as it is for you to understand the lecture, summarize it, and then do the practice question, but it's also very important for you to understand where your mistakes are coming from and why you're missing the questions. And the last thing you need to know about studying is that you need to review these concept summaries as often as possible. See, it's been scientifically proven that it takes one day for you to forget about 50 to 80% of the materials you have learned that day. It's known as the forgetting curve. And the only way to really retain that information is for you to constantly review. Maybe every other day, maybe every 2 days, keep reviewing that. And you might be wondering, wait, does that mean I have to review these concept summaries for the rest of my life? No, you silly. See, here's the thing. If you review it often enough, they're gonna stick. Think about addition, like 1+1. This too, right? You don't have to review addition every other day. That's not why you know it, right? You did it so many times that you just understand it and it's become part of you. Essentially, it has become part of your long-term memory. And in order for you to turn the materials you learn to become a long-term memory, you have to constantly review. Otherwise, you're gonna forget most of them. Remember those concept summaries you were making after you watched the lecture? See, we're making them so that you wouldn't have to waste time re-watching the whole lecture again. See, for example, the fractional lecture was about 41 minutes long. You don't have time to watch 41-minute lecture every single day for the rest of your life. No, you can't do that. I don't want you to spend 41 minutes to watch the whole lecture again just to review the concept. No, that's just a waste of your time. Instead, review with the summaries that you have made for every single one of these chapters. See, for every single one of them, you are going to be making a summary. And when you have to review 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 chapters worth of notes, you don't have to watch 7 lectures again. Rather, just look at the 7 summaries you made, and it's going to take you about 5 to 10 minutes, and that's it. And how often should you do it? Well, do it as often as possible, but at the minimum, at the bare minimum, skim through it a couple times throughout the week, maybe like 2 to 3 times. Ideally, 5 times every other day, that would be ideal. But start off with maybe 2 to 3 times a week and then work your way up. Then you will be set on these concepts. And extra bonus points if you have highlighted the weak points for emphasis, right? So within the summary, you're not gonna be weak on every single one of them. Maybe like this thing, one thing right there, you're kind of like shaky on, but these two things right there, you're like, you got them down. Then just highlight this portion so that when you are going through the summaries, you're putting most of your attention into the weak points. You don't need to get good at the stuff you are already good at. You just need to get better at stuff you're bad at. Does that make sense? Cool. So that's going to be the end of the summer study plan. And if you got to the end of this video, congratulations. You have the attention span of like top 5% of the United States. So let me give you a quick bonus. So here are a couple things that I have planned for you guys. So the first thing is going to be the phase two of the study plan. It's gonna tell you exactly what to do after your 28 days of studying is up. And to make studying for the SAT a lot easier, I'm going to be releasing a SAT math concept breakdown. You see guys, we know that a lot of things are tested on the SAT, but nobody tells you exactly what is tested on the SAT. A lot of books and a lot of websites will tell you, oh, this is on the SAT, this is on the SAT, this is on the SAT. But the thing is, we're not even sure if that is a complete list or if the list has way too many things in them so that you'll be wasting time studying for materials that are not even on the SAT in the first place. So to get around that, I'm going to be breaking down exactly what is on the SAT, and this is going to be a comprehensive list, and this is the only list you will ever need to know to understand exactly what is on the SAT and what is not on the SAT. It's going to be a very comprehensive list. And these videos, I'm going to be making about 5 of them, and they're going to be broken down into five of these categories. First, we're going to break down the basic math skills you need to know for the SAT. Then we're going to talk about every single function types that will show up in the SAT. Line functions, quadratic functions, cubic function, absolute value functions. Everything you need to know about these functions is going to be in this video. And third, we're going to learn about advanced algebra concepts, including synthetic division, complex numbers, and all that stuff. And next, we're going to talk about geometry. All the shapes that will show up in the SAT, I'm going to be putting it in this video. And last but not least, is the hardest concept for a lot of the students, and that is going to be word problems. You know those rate questions, you know those proportion questions? These tough questions about word problems, I'm going to be breaking them down and tell you exactly what you need to know for the SAT. If you're studying with me, with my program, SAT Math Accelerator, all these things are broken down in the program. You don't even have to worry about this. Every single one of these things are going to be in the program. However, if you're studying with some third-party website books, then you can use this list to make sure that what you're studying in the book is actually going to be covered on the SAT by checking it off with the list I'll be providing. So if the book is teaching you this one thing, then check it with the list. See if it's on the list. If it is, then you are learning the materials you actually need. But if it's not on the list, then you're wasting your time and you can just kind of skip over it. Does that make sense? Cool. So that's going to be it for this video, guys. If you guys have found this video helpful, make sure you hit this like button. I think it looks like that, maybe not. And if you want to see more of these videos and get notified when the videos for these things drop, then make sure you subscribe to the channel and turn the notification bell on, because you want to be the first one to watch these videos and get the most out of them. And as always, if you guys have any questions or comments, leave them in the comment section down below and I'll help you out. So thanks for tuning in. I'll see you on the next video.